Hello everyone, welcome back to Duffy, and today I'm going to show you how to install Optifine for Minecraft 1.17.1. So if you do go and enjoy this video, be sure to leave a like and also hit that subscribe button on this channel. I would really appreciate that because I'm going to be doing more of these type of videos, loads of tutorial type videos for Minecraft. And I also want to say as well that if you want to see how to get a background just like this, I will leave an eye up on screen so you can actually see that video on how to get a background just like this, so an animated background for your computer. But anyway, let's get straight into the video. So the first thing you're going to want to do is actually load up Minecraft. So my Minecraft's just down here and I'm going to load it up. So what you're going to want to do is actually click on the little button just down here, this little arrow, then come down and actually find the latest released, just like that. Once you do that, click on play. So you actually have to load up Minecraft first. So if you're installing Optifine for Minecraft 1.17.1, you have to load up the Minecraft version 1.17.1. As if you don't do that, it will not work. So yeah, make sure you actually load up the right version for your Optifine. Now once it's actually launched up, you can just click quit game just like that, and that is actually now done. So the next thing I want to do is actually head over to your Google or whatever browsing engine you actually use. Now the first thing I want to do is actually go over to Optifine. I will leave links in the description down below to actually download these. Now when you actually come over to the website, it might look like this. If it looks like this, just click on downloads just up here. And then as you can see, 1.17.1 just there. Click on preview versions, and just here you can actually download the latest version. Now some numbers will be different for other people, all depends on the version of the Optifine. So yeah, all you gotta do is click on the top one, that will be the latest version for Optifine. So click on download, and once you click on download, it might tell you to wait 5 seconds for like this ad to skip. Once the 5 seconds is over, you can click on skip just here. Now once you've done that, it will bring you straight over to this page just here. Just click on the download button just here, and then it will download just down here. Now it will take you over to an ad. You can just leave this, sort of go back into the Google just here. Now down here you can see it says this file could harm your computer. It pretty much won't harm your computer. I've downloaded probably like over 1,000 of these files and my computer is totally fine. You can click keep on that and it will download just like that. Now once it's actually finished downloading, I'm going to drag it to my desktop just there. You can close this page down now. So as you can see, I've got a jar file. As you can see, it's got like a little coffee mug just there. So if your file's not like this, it could be because you don't have Java installed. Now, I will leave a link in the description down below to this page just here to actually get Java. So once you come to this page, just click on the download button just here. Now once you've done this, you need to see if you've got 64-bit or 32-bit for your operating system. So how to check that is go down to your little search bar just down here in the corner, then put in operating system. Sorry, just put in system, and as you can see just here, come to your system settings. So I'll do that for, again just in case. So just put in system in here and click on the system just here. So once you've done this, you can see just here I've got a system type and it says 64-bit operating system, but if yours says 32-bit, that is okay as well. So yeah, mine says 64-bit, so what I'm gonna have to do is actually download 64-bit for Java for Windows. Now to actually find 64-bit, you have to click down here, as you can see just here, click on that link just there, and that will bring you over to a page just like this. And just here, you can see it says 64-bit browser. You need to download this for 64-bit. Now, if you have a 32-bit operating system, you will have to download 32-bit just there. So I have 64-bit, so I'll click on that one. Now, it will bring you to this little page just here. So all you got to do is actually find the 64-bit just here at the bottom. And then click on the manual page just here. And once you've done that, you have to click on the Windows offline 64-bit just there. So just click on that and it should download it for you just over here. So once you've done that, you have to click on it and actually install it. It can take a little while, so yeah, you can do that. I'm not going to do it because I've already got it installed. So yeah, I'm going to cancel mine and I'm going to close this page down now. So once you've got your Java installed, your file should turn like this. And if still if it's not like this, you can right click and click open with, and you can find your Java just here. But anyway, mine is already like this, so I'm just going to double click on this. Now what you got to do is actually find your .minecraft. So if this has got your .minecraft in here just like this, it will be fine. But if it hasn't, click on the three little dots and you have to find where you actually installed your Minecraft to. But mine has already got that there and that's all right. So I'm going to click on install. Now as you can see, it's got a little file just here and it says it has installed. So once it's installed, just click on OK and everything should close down. Now you can actually delete this file, you don't need that no more. Now what we want to do is actually load up Minecraft. Now once we get to this page just here, as you see automatically it has swapped over for me just here. But if it hasn't done this, just click on installations up here. Now if it's like this, you can't see it, just click on modify just over here and you will see it just here. So yeah, this is your Optifine for 1.17.1. Now we will say as well, what you want to do is click on these little three little dots just over here, then click on edit. Now if you come down here to more options, you can actually change the RAM gigabytes for this. So what I would do, I would actually recommend changing it up to 4. just like that. So it's probably best to check how much RAM you actually got for your computer, because if you've only got 4 GB of RAM on your computer, you might not want to swap this to 4, because then it will be overloaded on Minecraft. So the best thing to do is actually come down to your taskbar and just right click and click Task Manager just there. Now once you've done this, click on Performance, and over here you can see on the last bit just there, I have actually got 15.9 GB of RAM. But for you, it might be different. It might be 8 GB, it might be 4 GB, it might be 32 GB. It all depends on how much gigabytes of RAM or memory you have got on your computer. Now, if you've got 16, you should have plenty to actually put this up to 4. Or you could put this higher if you want to, but I recommend just having it 4. Now, if you have 8 GB of RAM, you might be able to put this up to 4. Just all depends, you have to test that. And if you've got 4 GB of RAM just on here, you would have to keep this on 2 or something like that, just down here. But if you've got enough, just put it on 4, because yeah, better for your Minecraft and it runs smoother. So once you've done that, you can click on save, then click back over to play just over here. Now you can actually load up your Minecraft, so just click on play and accept the risk and just click play. And once you've done that, it should just load up on Minecraft and you can just start playing Minecraft. You can do a few more options in your settings to make it run even better, but I won't be doing that in this video today. So as you see, if you click on options and click on video settings, as you can see, you've got your chunks up here. Now if you've got a 64-bit operating system and 64-bit Java installed, you can actually put this all the way up to 64 chunks, but I would not recommend that. So yeah, I will leave this down to around about 16. It's roughly around about good. All depends on your computer specs. Now for FPS, I'll just leave this all the way up the top to unlimited. And all this stuff, you just have to test with it and see if it runs on your computer fine. If you do want a tutorial on the best settings for Optifine, you can actually just let me know in the comments below or leave a like on this video and I can do that in the future. So basically now Optifine is installed. If you want to actually zoom in and stuff like that, click on the options button, then click on the controls. And if you come down here a little bit further, you will see the zoom button just down here. Now I've got mine set to F. This makes it so you can actually zoom in Minecraft and actually look a long way in game. So what I'll do, I'll actually go into a world just now and we can look in the distance with zoom. As you see, I'm in my world just here. So if I press F, I can actually zoom in and actually look off in distance for like, yeah, as you can see, I see things so far away. This is what Optifine does. Also, Optifine does boost your FPS as well in game and also makes it so you can run HD texture packs and also shaders. So if you want to know how to install shaders, let me know in the comments below. I will do a video on that as well, because shaders actually make your game look really good. As you can see here, I've got a shader pack installed right now. And yeah, it looks pretty good, the game. I really like it. It makes the water look really nice. And yeah, if you want to know how to install this stuff, let me know. You can get a bunch of shader packs out there and a bunch of texture packs. So yeah, let me know if you want to see that. Anyway, that's how you install Octavine for Minecraft 1.17.1. So if you did enjoy this video, remember to leave a like. Hit that subscribe button if you are new to this channel. I really appreciate that. And I'll see you guys all next time. Peace out.